Travel in London today on the Underground and there are three things on the tube system which you instantly associate with it, which you take for granted because they've always seemed to be there. The classic red circle and blue bar Roundel, the famous tube map, and the Johnston typeface are all integral to the Underground's history. But how and when did all these things come about? London's Underground Railway network started in 1863 by men with moustaches and big hats, when seven stations were built by the Metropolitan Railway Company between Paddington and Farringdon. They were an independent company, not part of an integrated system as we have today, and as rival independent railways also sprang up, they too had their own separate identities. These separate companies often built stations in the same part of London, sometimes with the same name too, which is why anomalies still exist today, such as there being two Edgware Road stations. But as the network started to grow, changes occurred to bring them all together, and with one identity too. In 1902, the UERL was formed, that's the Underground Electric Railways of London Limited, which brought together what we know now as the District, Bakerloo and Piccadilly lines, along with the Charing Cross branch of the Northern Line, and this was done by a man called Charles Tyson Yerkes. This was the start of all the lines coming together as one integrated network, but Yerkes died before his vision was finalised, and a man called Albert Henry Stanley, later Lord Ashfield, was appointed as the general manager of the URL, later becoming managing director and then ultimately the chairman for many years. After Ashfield took a trip on the Paris Metro, he was inspired by signage that he saw there to create a red disc for London known as the Bullseye, an example of which can still be seen today on the westbound platform of Covent Garden Station, although this is a replica and not an original. In 1907, he promoted a man called Frank Pick to be head of publicity, who was initially in charge of promoting tube travel with these wonderful, colourful posters. Pick then employed a gentleman called Edward Johnston to design a new typeface for the Underground to use, a specification of which is that it had to stand out from all the advertisements which often cluttered the walls of Underground stations at the time. The Johnston typeface, later New Johnston and today known as Johnston 100, was introduced in 1916 and is, over 100 years later, such a success that it's used everywhere on the Underground. Okay, maybe not here at Tower Hill or here at Waterloo, so let's not mention those. Following on from that, the Metropolitan Railway, which we know now as the Metropolitan Line, introduced their own diamond-shaped roundel, and you can see a replica of one of those today at Moorgate Station. It was shortly after in 1917 when Johnston and his typeface brought this to station signage too, and this is when the roundel, the symbol today which stands for transport in London, first appeared. And finally, onto the tube map that we have today. Based on a design by a gentleman called Henry Beck, that's Harry to his friends, he was working as a draftsman for LU, and he looked at the current map of the time and sketched up his own version, which he then designed properly and took to the publicity department in 1931, but it was initially rejected. So he tried again a year later, and this time they said yes, and a limited number were produced. By the way, if you're in possession of an early tube map, this one is from 1948, they're worth loads of money on eBay. And his design has stayed ever since, with the map evolving over time as new parts of the network have been added. Which is why, though, you'll always see a credit to Harry Beck down in the corner of every new tube map printed today. And that's how these three London Underground classic designs came into existence. The Johnston typeface in 1916, the Roundel in 1917, and the tube map in 1932.